The fact, therefore, must be regarded as established as firmly as any fact recorded in the annals of the Convention that on the day when Pinckney presented his draft to the Convention, he did not deliver and could not have delivered a speech making 27 pages of printed matter. There is another fact to be considered in connection with the foregoing. Between the opening statements of the observations and the title of the pamphlet, there is a flat contradiction. In the speech, he says expressly that the plan will admit of important amendments, that he does not seem to offer it for the consideration of the House, that he has taken the liberty of mentioning it because it was his duty to do so. In the title to the pamphlet, he says, "Plan of Government submitted to the Federal Convention in Philadelphia on the 28th of May, 1787. It is plain that the speech and its title were written at different times, and that in this the two are irreconcilable. It is also plain that Pinckney, when he wrote a title for the printer in New York, had forgotten the detail of the contents of the speech and did not take the trouble to examine it. We may therefore conclude that the two events were far apart, the one having taken place in Charleston before the assembling of the convention,